Right, here we have it, close up of the dreaded tricopter, which isn't so dreaded after all. This was a series, it's a 3D printed, my own design, 3D printed. And when I say the own design, I should be ashamed when I say that because I knocked it up in maybe half an hour or so and printed it out. And as you can see, I think I broke the cover already. Yeah, I broke the cover before I even put it in the air for the KK board. Now this thing, I just thought I'd build it on a whim. Never had a tricopter. I thought I'd give a try. I had a load of spare parts from my Gowies. So I thought I'd build something with it. And this is pretty much the, let's have a look, the Gowie motors are on there. And also the Gowie 18 amp ESC. So I thought I'd port it all onto here. And also I'm using the KK2 board. Now I absolutely hate all these KK type boards. I've had nothing but failure and destruction with my KK boards. Flipping, crashing, dropping out the sky for no reason, just not, just everything, you name it, I've had the KKs do it. But this KK2, I've got to say, I don't know what firmware it is. I know it's the latest one. It's got the self-leveling on. And I have been using the auto self-level just whilst I get this thing dialed in a little bit. All the PID setting type things, they've all come from someone else's, not mine, because I don't really have much experience with setting all of those up on this type one. So I've used someone else's, and I've got to say, it flew pretty well. This was the second time. First time I put it in the air, it was the tail mechanism. I had it decked over too far to compensate for the rotation of it. But it was just crazy trying to control it. My thumbs were going like mad. There were just a blur on the sticks, and that was just to keep it in a hover. So next day I re-centered this. I just centered it rather than having an offset on it. Centered the tail mech, and it worked really well. It was a little bit misbalanced again with the battery as well. I moved that a little bit further forward because I kept finding it was coming back on me. But a little bit of trim today, and a little bit more adjustment of the battery. And it was good. I've got to say, I had a big, huge smile on my face all the time. La Mind you, I think it was laughing mainly due to the fact that I was waiting for the time it would crash. I just threw it around like crazy. And yeah, I loved it. The auto leveling was good. I think I liked it because you really had to concentrate. It wasn't one of those that just hung in the air. You really had to watch what it was doing. It seemed to go better in forward flight. Strange characteristics to it in forward flight, but and the tail, this, I don't know if that's the norm, but this was absolutely shaking like crazy. It's really oscillating. If I was making this again, I would, oh well, at the time when I wanted to make this, I wanted 12 millimeter wood, but I could only find 10 millimeters, so it's based on a 10 millimeter wood, but it's just not stiff enough. I can bend it and shake it just because of the length of it. Ideally, you could maybe shorten this, reduce a bit of the vibration from it or the bend in it. But it's still, considering it was bending like mad, the KK2 came up trumps, and it kept it in the air nicely. I've got to say, more than impressed with the KK board. It's a huge improvement on what I was used to, so it was a welcome surprise when it did work that well. I need to get now the weight of it again. If this one, ironically, could do with more weight to it. I was running it on a 1800 3-cell battery. Again, I'm kind of limited with the 3 cells because of the ESCs, 3-cell rated, and also these motors are 3-cell rated. So I'm going to stick with these 1800s, which I've had laying around. And that was not a bad weight, I've got to say. I've got decent flight time, not sure what it was. I gave up flying before it ran out of battery. So all in all, this was a really fun one to fly. As you can see, it's not, there's bits sticking out, the screw heads are sticking out, these are sticking up from below because it used to have that weird skid plate going on there. So it's all a bit of a mess, but it just goes to show that even a mess can go in the air quite nicely. I've seen loads of people fly these things, and you see the state of some of them, and you think, how can they fly? But yeah, trust me, they do fly. If you can sort out the tail mechanism, I'm fortunate that I got a 3D printer and I was able to get that sorted out, but I'm not sure if you can buy them now. Mine's specific to the servo that I had, so it's kind of a difficult one. If you can get a yaw mechanism, then you're pretty much there. The rest of it, easy to do. You can make it out of wood, I guess. I'm definitely going to redo the files for this. I need to get a GoPro camera mount of some kind. I'm going to base it on those wired mounts that I have somehow. I'm not sure yet. I need to integrate the KK board as well into this. It's got some kind of weird off stand going on at the moment. And let's see, the Spectrum receiver. This is only El Cheapo orange one. That was about £5, something like that. Not sure about the range. I'll probably have to swap that out at some point. But for now, it's certainly held up. Didn't go that far, but it certainly held up. And this will definitely be going back in the air. I had to stop flying it because I knew I was going to stuff it into the trees or into the ground. I just got a little bit complacent and a little bit carried away throwing it around. So it's not really a huge deal if it breaks because I've got loads of wood in stock ready. And like I say, I'm going to redo all the front, all the Ultimaker 3D printed parts. I'm going to redo anyway, so they don't matter that much. The tail mech, it works. I'm not happy with it. It's not the best design in the world, but it does work. So unsure about that. I'd like to make it so it would take or accept more different versions of servos. At the moment, it's just specific to mine, so I'd rather do it so anyone can just get any servo and more or less fit it in there. Certainly fast enough. Certainly does the task. I've kept it in the air. It's got to be a good thing, right? But yeah, if you haven't built one of these and you've flown quads, definitely have a go at building one of these. They are good fun. They're a bit like a sports model, the way you can throw them around. Cheap to do, and if you crash it, all the wiring's ready and just throw it on another one. So definitely gonna explore this one a little bit more. I'd be nervous flying it longer distance, and I think I'd be nervous flying it FPV. But you never know. That's definitely the way to progress this thing, and definitely see this one in the air very shortly, or in a tree, or face planted, who knows.